120. I worked hard. Too hard. I worked hard. Bismillah ar-Rahman. Assalamu alaikum, my dear students. My name is Muhammad Numan. How are you, my dear students? I hope you will be fine. Welcome to Advanced English Grammar. Today I'm going to talk about the difference between well and would. Where to use these two words correctly? Because these two words create much confusion among the students, either to use well or would. So let's talk about these two words. First, we have to talk about the word well. The word well we use for the future. Whenever we are talking about that action which will be done in the future, we use over there the word well. The word well we use for the distant future. Or you can also say, we use the word well when we are sure about something in the future. For the strong intention, we also use the word well. For example, he will be in Canada tomorrow. For the distant future, I used here the word well instead of would. Now let's take another example. I will send you all the details by email. This action will be done in the future. When we are going to expect something in the future, we use over there the word well. Keep in your mind. Instead of well, I can also use would, but for the near future. You cannot say, for example, I will send you, this is for the distant future. But if I say, when I'm going to do some action, when I'm going to do the action in the near future, I will use would instead of well. How? I would send you all the details by email. For the immediate action, we use there the word would. You cannot use the word well in the near future. For the near future, we use the word would instead of well. Okay, now let's talk about the word would. The word would has a lot of uses. It is used in the past, in the present, and in the future. These two words are modal words. Keep in your mind. Past tense of well. The word would is the past tense of well. First, we are going to talk about that action which has done in the past. Example, we thought we would be in Africa by 2 o'clock. We use there the word would in the past, not in the present or in the future. We use the word would. But this action is not a real action. We were imagining something. We are imagining something. For the imagination, we use there the word would. Because we were expecting something in the past, but it was not happened. We use there the word would. Okay, we use the word well in would for in the conditional sentences also. How? The first conditional sentence, we use in the first conditional sentence well. Real situation, first conditional sentence, if it rains, I will bring my umbrella. So it means this is the real action. For for the real situation action, we use the word well. When we are certain about something, we use the word well. In the second conditional sentences, we use the word would rather than well. Imaginary situation. Would. Example, if I had wings, I would fly all over the world. But how could it possible? It is not possible. We are going to imagine something. We are just expecting something. We use there the word would for on the real situation. Okay, now let's talk about for the polite expressions, we use the word would. The first sentence, I would fly, would you mind lending me some money? Would you mind lending me some money? The ing form has come here. This is the correct form. Rules and regulation are here. These are correct. Would you mind lending me some money? The correct form is this. You have to use this form, ing form, okay, with the verb. Would you mind lending me some money? For the request, I use would you mind. Would you mind, okay? Another sentence, would you mind if I left a little early tomorrow? I use this sentence for offer. Sorry, for permission. When we are going to take permission from our boss, from our teacher, from our master, we use there the word, would you mind if I left? But the second form is used here, left, but it gives us the meaning of the future. These are the rules which are being taught by me as well as by you. Okay, would it be okay, it has used for permission. Another sentence for permission, would it be okay if I left a little early tomorrow? Again, we use the structure for the permission. There are different structures, so you can adopt which one you can. Okay. We use for offer, would you like some more milk in your coffee? We use this sentence for offer, okay? When you are going to give offer to someone, we use the structure. Would you like some milk in your coffee? Would you like? And for want, we use I would like to buy a marker. We use the structure. I would like to buy a marker. We use for want the structure. So it was our today class about the word well and would. And I hope you would have gotten these points. So do subscribe our channel. The name of our channel is Spreading the Useful Knowledge. Share these videos to your friends, relatives through WhatsApp, Messenger and Facebook. That would be very kind of you. Thanks a lot of you. Thanks, Amanda.